Frank Mir's name is a staple in the UFC heavyweight division. At 25 years old, he became a UFC champion, and it really seemed like it was only going up for Mir. But after a motorcycle accident that stripped him of his title, he continued on with his career where he had many falls, but also many victories. So how good was Frank Mir actually? Hey guys, it's Kiiyon, and today I want to talk about former UFC heavyweight champion Frank Mir. This one was requested by a lot of you guys, so I finally wanted to deliver on it. Also, shout out to the undisputed members of my Patreon. You can get your name right here, as well as early access to videos like this one. Now let's get to the video. Frank Mir made his debut in 2001, where he racked up two wins on the local circuit before entering the UFC in November of that year, where he fought Roberto Travin. In this fight, Mir landed a stiff jab before dropping Roberto with a combo. From there, the Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu specialist and Frank immediately secured an armbar that forced the tap. It was an impressive win considering Travin was a submission wrestling champion. Mir followed this win with an inside shoulder lock against Pete Williams that ended the fight in 46 seconds. Frank's next fight was in London, England against Ian Freeman. Mir connected with a couple nice high kicks before being taken down and receiving heavy ground and pound from Freeman. Even when he got back on the feet, Ian was connecting with heavy punches and knees. Frank retaliated with a takedown and attempted the heel hook when it was on the ground. But his head was completely exposed when attempting the submission, which gave Freeman the opportunity to tee off. Once he was in Mir's guard, he connected with more heavy ground and pound. When ref John McCarthy stopped the fight to check on a cut on Frank's face, Mir was stumbling on his way back to his corner, which ultimately forced McCarthy to call off the fight, handing him his first professional loss. Regardless, he came back at UFC 41 to fight Tank Abbott. In this fight, Frank immediately pulled guard and attempted a few arm bars. He was able to secure a toe hold that forced the tap, making this the only toe hold in UFC history till this day. The fight lasted 45 seconds. Frank went on to fight Wes Sims at UFC 43. He secured the takedown early and made his way to the mount where he threw down ground and pound. He then attempted a rear naked choke, but to no success. Then he attempted an armbar but got slammed out of it by Wes, who then began stomping on the ground at Mir while grabbing the cage. Mir was unable to continue, which caused this illegal move to disqualify Sims and award the win to Frank. So the two fought again at UFC 64, with Mir taking the fight down, landing ground and pound, and finishing the fight with the first round KO by knees and punches. In June of 2004, Frank fought former UFC heavyweight champion Tim Sylvia for the vacant title. Tim was the favorite going into the fight as he was undefeated and had more experience than Frank. But after Mir got taken down early, he secured an armbar that broke Sylvia's forearm. The fight was only 50 seconds, and at the age of 25, Frank Mir became the UFC heavyweight champion. But in September of 2004, Mir got into a motorcycle accident after another car hit him. He was out due to injury for 14 months before the UFC decided to strip him of his belt. He finally came back in 2006 to fight Marcio Cruz. Early on, it looked like Mir's leg gave out from his motorcycle injury. He then got taken down where he received ground and pound from Cruz, with one of the shots being an elbow that opened a cut on Frank's head and started bleeding profusely. Herb Dean stopped the fight to check the cut. Mir was saying how he could only see out of his left eye, which would have immediately stopped the fight today. But Frank wanted to continue, which showed a lot of heart. Yet when the fight restarted back on the floor, Marcio continued to throw heavy ground and pound from above that eventually forced Herb Dean to stop the fight. It was a huge upset for Mir, but he took the loss on the chin and said that he was going to come back and not give up. So he came back at UFC 61 to fight Dan Christensen in a fight many believed Frank would easily finish. But he was on defense for a lot of the fight when he took punches from Dan and fought off an armbar attempt as well. But Frank was able to control Dan on the ground where he landed heavy ground and pound that opened up a cut. After three rounds, the fight was close, but Frank would go home with the victory. His next fight at UFC 65 was a title eliminator against Brandon Vera. And it ended in 69 seconds after Vera connected with a right hand, a few knees, and a barrage of ground and pound strikes that forced the ref, Steve Mazzagatti, to stop the fight. After a disappointing 2006, Mir came back in 2007 to fight Anthony Hardonk, who he finished in 77 seconds into the first with a Kimura that forced a tap. He came back at UFC 81 to fight newcomer and WWE star Brock Lesnar. Lesnar immediately went for the takedown, but after landing some ground and pound shots, Steve Mazzagatti stopped the action due to one of the shots hitting the back of Frank's head, which was really controversial when it happened. Regardless, when the fight started back up, Mir got dropped again and it really looked close to being finished. But after attempting a few armbars to slow down the action, he finally secured a knee bar that forced Brock to tap. The win was huge for Frank, and he brought that momentum to his next fight against interim heavyweight champion Antonio Rodrigo Nogueira, who he also coached the Ultimate Fighter against prior to the bout. Mir was aggressive early with his striking before securing a takedown. When it got back up, Frank continued to find success with his striking, so much so that he dropped Nogueira with a left and the fight looked so close close to being finished. But Mir backed off to conserve his gas tank and avoid any submissions from Antonio. Before the end of the round, he dropped Nogueira again. In round 2, Mir continued to showcase his improved boxing before dropping Big Nog again. But this time, he finished him off with strikes on the floor. Frank Mir became the UFC interim heavyweight champion, which gave him the chance to unify it against the champion, Brock Lesnar. In their highly anticipated rematch at UFC 100, Mir attempted to grab a leg early, but to no success. He ended up on his back where Brock delivered heavy ground and pound. This continued for the remainder of the round, and by the end of it, Frank was busted up. In the second round, Mir connected with a left hand and a knee to the body of Lesnar, which hurt him bad. But Brock took the fight to the ground and began throwing heavy ground and pound shots that ultimately stopped the fight. Following this title loss, Frank bounced back with a win against Czech Congo, where he landed a big left before securing the guillotine choke that put Congo to sleep. The fight lasted 72 seconds. This impressive performance saw him fight Shane Carwin for the vacant interim heavyweight championship. Carwin was undefeated and never had a fight past the first round. And that's what happened in this fight with Mir. After feeling each other out on the feet, Shane connected with heavy shots in the clinch that ultimately called a stop to the fight. In September of 2010, Frank came back to fight Miracle Krokop. The fight was lackluster as both men were unable to land any significant shots. Until a minute left into the fight when Frank connected with a knee that knocked out Krokop. At UFC 130, he fought Roy Nelson, who he dominated everywhere in the fight from the stand-up to the takedowns and to the heavy shots when on top. He won the unanimous decision and went on to fight Antonio Rodrigo Nogueira for a second time. Mir took the fight down early. But when the fight got back up, Nogueira began connecting with strikes and Frank looked like he was out on his feet. When it got to the ground, it looked like he was fully out. That's when Nogueira stopped the punches and attempted a guillotine choke. But Mir was able to get out and attempt a Kimura that had both men rolling around in dramatic fashion. The fight ended when Frank snapped Nogueira's arm after he refused to tap, making him the only man to finish Nogueira by strikes and submission. He then replaced Alistair Overeem to fight heavyweight champion Junior Dos Santos at UFC 146. Frank desperately attempted to take down Junior, but he was unable to, and this gave Dos Santos the opportunity to pick Mir apart on the feet and almost finish him before the end of the first round. That momentum from JDS carried to the second round where he finished Mir with a big right before adding more ground strikes. On April 20th, 2013, Frank fought former Strikeforce heavyweight Grand Prix champion Daniel Cormier. Daniel was the aggressor from the start as he pressed forward with his striking, controlled Mir in the clinch, and did not allow Frank to connect with anything significant. Mir lost the unanimous decision and went on to fight Josh Barnett at UFC 164. The two were swinging early at each other before Barnett connected with a knee that knocked Mir out. Frank's next fight was against former Strikeforce heavyweight champion, Alistair Overeem. Overeem dominated Mir throughout the three rounds with his striking on the feet and on the ground. Following this four-fight losing streak, Frank fought Antonio Bigfoot Silva and where Mir was the betting underdog. But with a minute 40 into the fight, Mir connected with a left hook that dropped Bigfoot before finishing the fight on the ground with heavy elbows. It was an awesome comeback for Frank and he continued that momentum against Todd Duffy in July of 2015. The fight was even faster than Mir's last one when him and Duffy were throwing haymakers from the very beginning. Eventually, Frank connected with a counter left that knocked Todd out cold. Now, after this win, it really felt like we were witnessing a Frank Mir renaissance. So the UFC matched him up with Andrei Arlovsky, who was also going through a career resurgence. The fight went down at UFC 191. In a competitive bout that saw both men connect with shots, Mir was the aggressor when he brought the fight to the floor and threw some heavy ground and pound. The fight went all three rounds and Arlovsky would go on to win the decision, which was controversial among many, including UFC president Dana White. After this loss, Frank went to Brisbane, Australia to fight Mark Hunt. After trading shots in the first 3 minutes of the fight, Hunt would then connect with a right hand that knocked Mir out. After this loss, Frank tested positive for a turinabol metabolite and was suspended for 2 years. But Mir maintained his innocence by stating he probably took tainted supplements. This tension with USADA pushed Frank to wanting out of the UFC so he can go back to fighting in another promotion. And after 16 years with the UFC, Mir signed with Bellator MMA in 2017, with his first fight being against former Pride heavyweight champion Fedor Emelianenko in the opening round of the heavyweight Grand Prix. Mir was able to clip Fedor early, but Emelianenko came back with a takedown and knees to the body. Frank came rushing in to attack Fedor, but would get clipped by a combo that sent him down where he was finished by strikes. The fight lasted for 48 seconds. Mir lost his next fight to Javi Ayala after looking good early with his striking and takedowns before tapping to strikes that caused an alveolar ridge fracture. But he won his next fight in a rematch against Roy Nelson, where he dominated Roy in the stand-up by attacking with the inside leg leg kick throughout the three rounds, earning him the unanimous decision. And since that fight in 2019, that was the last time we saw the 40-year-old Mir fight. He will most likely continue to fight against other legends in the sport, but his time as one of the world's best heavyweights is over. So after going 19-13 in a career that saw him win the UFC Undisputed and Interim Heavyweight Championships, how good was Frank Mir actually? In my opinion, he was the best jiu-jitsu fighter in the history of the UFC heavyweight division. 8 out of his 16 wins were by submission, which is the most in the division's history, and a lot of them are memorable due to the adversity he had to face prior to securing them. He also holds notable records such as the only toehold finish and the fastest submission in UFC heavyweight history, with those two records being broken a single night. I know there are other heavyweights that possess incredible jiu-jitsu skills, but they didn't showcase it like Frank did in the UFC. His stand-up improved a lot over the course of his career. His left hand and knees were his go-to attacks, and it proved to be very effective to either finish a fight or set up a takedown. But the biggest thing I loved about Frank's career was his ability to come back when everyone wrote him off. He had career resurgence after career resurgence. He took losses like a champion and didn't let it dictate the narrative of his career, which is what many people respected Mir for.
I would consider Frank to be in the top 15 of greatest heavyweights of all time.
Personally, I could have seen him hold that belt for a very long time. The only real top heavyweights in the UFC were Tim Sylvia and Andrei Arlovsky, and those were two men that I believe were not as good as Frank at that point. In fact, he probably could have broken the title defense record had he stayed around to defend his belt, which could have possibly led him to become the greatest heavyweight of all time. But even though his career didn't play out the way that many thought it was going to, it still turned out to be very legendary regardless of the setbacks that came his way. My name is Kiiyon, and this was my take on how good Frank Mir actually was. Do you agree, disagree, or have something else to add? Please put it in the comments down below, because I'd love to read it. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel for more content like this. But that's all I have for now, so I'll see you on my next one.